The Arizona rampage has many politicians reevaluating their own security tonight.
And some are even questioning whether the shootings are a sign that the political climate has become poisonous. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh is live in our newsroom with more on this. Carrie.
The House suspended its normal business for the week to give members time to deal with the tragedy and organize their own security protocols. I spoke with Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger's press secretary today. She says the congressman is determined to keep interacting with the public, but he wants to make sure he and his constituents are not put at risk.
The nation's capital came to a standstill at 11 a.m. Monday morning. From the White House to the Supreme Court, hundreds gathered with heads bowed. A tribute to the victims of the Tucson shootings. In the wake of Saturday's six slayings and the attempted murder of Arizona Congressman Gabrielle Giffords, some members of both parties say it's time to ramp back inflammatory political rhetoric.
We're asking everyone to try to calm down some of the rhetoric. We don't want to make any assumptions about cause and effect, but I think it's important that we watch the words that we use. Words do have consequences, and let's try to tone down a little bit the rhetoric and the volume level.
Psychologist Victor Welzan of the International Critical Incident Stress Foundation assesses threats that come into dignitaries. He says politicians don't have to water down their views to communicate effectively, but
I think more respectful communication goes a long way to decreasing everybody's tension. And I'm not saying that could have prevented something like this, but you know, again, you're looking for those things that are flashpoints.
Looked at it on both sides.
Security consultant Bob Open makes a living spotting those flashpoints before they erupt. We asked his best advice for members of Congress who want to continue to mingle with their constituents.
You take these events out from the normal street corner, if you will, and go into, you know, go into an office complex or a community hall where you have some checkpoints and some choke points whereby you can screen people coming in.
Oatman adds that every safeguard buys law enforcement time to identify a potential attacker because he says most give themselves away before they pull the trigger.
Just his mannerisms alone, I'll guarantee you, he had his hand on that gun and he was constantly checking it.
Mr. Oatman also cautions that whenever you have a high-profile rampage like this, there's a risk of copycat crimes arising. That's why he emphasizes the need for increased vigilance on the part of politicians. To that end, Congressman Ruppersberger's staff tells us they asked the Capitol Police to come in and do a threat assessment for their offices, and they plan to inform local law enforcement every time the congressman hosts an event in his district. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.